You are loaded with great potentials, but somehow your life could seem empty and dry. All you need is the Word to come to the place of faith, blessing, and destiny. Your life can be maximized
because the Word of God says so. Because the Word of God says so.
Maximize your life with Dr. Chris Williams.
Glory to God.
So communication, it can be miscommunication, non-communication. What is the antidote? Learn communication. In these 2 months, we probably will still talk about love languages, how somebody is, what is the concept of love languages about? Somebody is trying to communicate love, but they are communicating it in their own language. So the person they are communicating love to isn't understanding them. Praise the Lord. So it's like I'm speaking in my native language to Bishop Son. I'm talking, he can see that I'm talking, I'm trying to communicate to him, but he isn't picking it because he does not understand Ubuluku. Praise God. He doesn't. And then if he decides to speak to me, the root ire is irekiti. I may not understand. Praise the Lord. You say, what is the whatever? We are going to do self-diagnosis these 2 months. You are going to sit down and find out what is causing pressure in my home. And then we are going to recommend books. We are going to get books. We are going to sit down and read books and grow together. Praise the Lord. Like I told you on Sunday, there are many unbelievers that are happy in marriage. Many. And there are many Christians that are unhappy. Reason, they have just refused to learn. They're not, you don't need to go and read mass communication before you can communicate effectively with your spouse, do you? You don't. Just pick a couple of books and read them. Learn about, that's all. Praise the Lord. So the essence of this talk is not to major on each one, but to point them out so that you can, I think that area is causing issues. And then you can begin to deal with it. Go pack books. Praise the Lord. And that's why associate of ours left many years ago was in those shoes. Again, when they wanted to get him, I told him, I said, this guy, you like book, you love knowledge. He has a teaching anointing, and teachers love knowledge. They love wisdom. I said, this babe you brought to me, she appears somebody who is just complacent with everyday Christian living. I said, I will do. So we arranged a day, and they did. Praise the Lord. I do. Before long, issues started. The lady just loves Nollywood. From morning till night, Nollywood. He said, I have books. In fact, praise God. Help me tell somebody, think twice. I first saw it coming when he said they were still cutting. The first time the lady came to his house, there was nothing. Sitting room, very big sitting room, totally empty. Bedroom, only one bed. But plenty of books. Plenty. Books everywhere. So the lady commented, what is this book we are going to be living on in this house? When he said it, I picked it. She said that about your books? Because the person I was talking to, he just like me. Praise God. She talked down your books. You probably are not very compatible. They went ahead. Issues till next tomorrow. Just patching it. Because one refuses to grow. One refuses to learn. Glory to God. So communication. Another one is sex. And like I said, there's none of these points that cannot be corrected, that you cannot grow into, that you cannot change into. Eastern Church, we must respect knowledge. The way some of us respond to knowledge is amazing. It never stops amazing me. Knowledge is power. Knowledge is life. Praise the Lord. Dr. Edeko said, if you are fasting and waiting on God, he said, spend 75% of that time studying and only 25% praying. But we want to turn it around. Oh God, oh God, oh God. You want to put on God all the responsibility that you should be bearing. Glory to God. He said, when you have prayed 25%, go give the rest present to studying. He said, as you are studying, God will be showing you things, knowledges that will help you to resolve the things you are facing. But alas, many people, they just deshine knowledge. As I can't. It's as foolish. That kind of attitude is as foolish as, what are they doing 6 years in medical school? What's that? My uncle was a pharmacist. There is nothing they know I don't know. We went to pharmacy council at Abeokuta recently. And one of the chemists, they had lost his chemist. So many of them came. They were trying to lobby so that they would reopen them. And one of them was saying, they introduced my wife as a pharmacist. What do pharmacy know? We know more than themselves. Others, shut up. Don't stop saying that. What do you do? She just kept quiet. It was his peers that hushed him down. When you begin to think that you know more than somebody who went to school 6 years, something is wrong with the person. Praise the Lord. Same way, there's no way you can know more than somebody who spends hours on end studying about an issue. And most especially, applying it. Am I communicating? I hear that in Winners, as part of the family that's marriage counseling demands, the couple has to read 15 books together. How many books? 15 books. It's part of is it prerequisite before they certify you? 15. Some of us are married now, 4 years, 5 years. You have not read up to 4 books on marriage. And then I like the revelation that Winners pastor that was listening to brought out. He said, even Jesus believed that knowledge is powerful in marriage. He said, he quoted that verse. There's a verse in the Bible that says, did you not read from the books? How that in the beginning, God said it was not so. That's powerful revelation. He said Jesus expected them to have read. Praise the Lord. Knowledge can help all these fighting and bickerings. Knowledge. I told you how we were fighting and then Revelation coming came. Then after 1 week, I went to collect, to repossess my wife. Praise the Lord. And he said, sit down. And he said, now listen. If you rate all the quarrelings and fights that myself and my wife have ever done in our marriage life, 98% of them are not that she's wicked to me, I'm wicked. It's probably because I'm not satisfied with the way she treated this or this other person or this other person. Literally 98%. It's always because of why you should have been more patient or you should have been more this. So he said, I see what is happening here. You are a teacher, you are the leader, you are the pastor. You have gone ahead on your understanding, but you are trying to use your own standard to deal with her. And he said that he's also a teacher. He said, we teachers, we always fall into that trap. He said, if it was another church leader or pastor that dealt with that person like that, you would not have picked up a quarrel with that person. He said, but because she is your wife, you think that she should know as much as you know. He said, no, that's very wrong. He said he was in that trap many years. Pastors, teachers, people who know too much, they want, especially people around them, to deal in knowledge almost like them. Literally, this thing set me free. Praise the Lord. So if I stand now and I see the way she's handling an issue, and I think she should have handled it a bit better, all I would say, you should have done that. So no more quarrel. Praise the Lord. Literal deliverance. I wrote it on a paper. I stuck it behind our door. 5 years running now. Are you still here or you have gone home? Are you still here or you have gone home? Something as little as that, I mean, was just harassing us. Praise God. So sex. Sexual dissatisfaction. Or sexual unfulfillment. Either because of frigidity, that sexual non-responsiveness, or ignorance of how to do, praise the Lord. There are some people so holy, they just don't know how to do, praise God. It can be learned. It can be what? It can be learned. I went to facilitate at family school last week. And I think praise had come that day. Praise for Wowe. So when I entered the room of the administrator, I saw some books. One of the books, very thick back book, very almost double this size and like this. I saw like three of them. I said, where did these books come from? They said they bought it from Praise. One woman had bought them. 4,000 each one. That's 12,000 naira. Praise the Lord. I mean, with that book, you can earn a degree in satisfying your husband in sex. Literally, praise the Lord. You can earn a degree in ravishing your wife. Glory to God. But not many people will go to touch, go near such things. They won't bother. Okay, let me prove it to you now that God, you need for God to help you. Somebody say, I need God for God to help me. I've been announcing in this church that I have a page, Sexual Fulfillment in Marriage. If you have heard it before and you have never gone there and you are having issues with sex, you need God to help you. You see that? You need God to help you. You need to help you. You need to increase your affinity for knowledge. Praise the Lord. You need to increase your affinity for knowledge. Because the same, one post, 600 people reached. One post, 700 people reached. One post, glory to God. Hundreds of people reading it, and you are here under me. And I've been saying, they put it up every Sunday, and you are having issues. God needs to help us. Praise the Lord. Is somebody learning something? Help me tell somebody, go for knowledge. Everything is there. Erectile dysfunction. Somebody's something can't do. Impotence. That's erectile dysfunction. Premature ejaculation. My husband is too wild. My husband is perverted. He wants some other things that I can't do. They are all there. You just go there and read and study. Praise the Lord. I bet maybe many singles will be sneaking in there reading it. Meanwhile, there's somebody who has a real-time issue with that area of life has never gone there. Praise the Lord. How did I know those things? From years reading, studying along those lines. Just studying, studying. Somebody say, I can do it. Say it one more time, I can do it. One of us got married. And after about a year and a half, I don't know what we're saying. He said, I was just trying to, you know, make a joke with him. I hope you guys are enjoying yourself. I said, no. He said, it's only almost like once in 4 months. I said, what did you say? Once in 4 months. He said he has to beg, he has to plead, he has to intercede. Then I made a joke, include it in confession, praise God. I said, call your wife for me. Call your wife for me. Apparently, the woman is having frigidity. Frigidity is a whole subject in medicine. A woman is not responding, doesn't desire sex and all that. But it is treatable. Praise the Lord. Then when the man went, I said, no wonder. This guy, many times, is not very effective on the job. I thought to myself, how can somebody be lying next to that kind of angel? And you are only seeing, you can't touch. Call her for me. Sat her down. Sit down. What are you doing? Want to push this man out? We pleaded. Thereafter, thank God she bought into that and corrected it. Praise the Lord. I brought that example because somebody may be in this service. Every time. No. My ear is spinning me. My ear. This one is spinning me. No. It's my jacket. My jacket is spinning me. You always give me an excuse. Go there and study. Study and get liberated, praise the Lord, so that you'll be happy in your marriage. What other causes? Roles displacement. Assumption of roles not assigned to individuals can place unnecessary stress on a marriage. Husband can't win bread, so the woman has to do it all, sometimes, for some time, or permanently. I mean, sometimes life just works out like that. Either temporarily or permanently, the woman has upper hand somehow. But number one, roles displacement should not be encouraged. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It shouldn't be encouraged. However, if because of a season of life, it is like that, there's something, knowledge can help you. If a woman understands, for instance, that it's just a privilege for her to be playing that role at that time, it won't cause no problem. Praise the Lord. And then the man understands also, this must not continue. At some point, these things should revert. It should change. And he's doing his best. He's working hard. That marriage will not have stress. Praise the Lord. Won't have stress. That marriage will not have stress. But if a woman, because she has maybe upper hand financially or anything, becomes the head, permanent head of a home, there will be issues in that home. Because this man you are seeing, men generally, they have what you call the ego. Somebody say ego. No man can be perpetually subordinate to a woman that he married with his money and be happy. No matter who the woman is, she's a professor and he's a laborer. Praise the Lord. No matter. She's the one who tells everybody what to do in the home. I told you about the situation I handled. they've been married for like 4 years. And in all 4 years, that woman, is the wife, has not lived in the man's house for more than a total of 11 months in 4 years. So I said, what is happening? The guy said, it's my wife's mother. That's my mother-in-law. Very strong choleric. Dickino. Any small thing. Come to the house. And then that come, you will think like, come and collect something and return. For the next 6 weeks, she's under abo, imprisonment, in the mother's house. So this last one he came, he said, for the past 4 months, my wife has been gone, living in her father's house. So I said, go there and call, go there and meet the man. Leave the woman. See, the woman is not thinking straight. Go and meet the baba. Is his father still alive? Say, yes. He said, I went. And the man said, anything that mommy says, that is how it will be. That's why there's an issue. That's why I proposed. I said, but you, that means you didn't marry right. He said, it's not my fault, sir. He said, we courted for like 2 years. And in all 2 years, there was only once I entered their family house. Another time, I dropped her in front of the house. Praise the Lord. Other times, I would drop her a pole away. So why were you doing that? Because of the lioness of the tribe of that family. Praise God. Any home where the woman wants is like that will have issues. Praise the Lord. Issues. That's why Bible says in Ephesians, can we say it? Ephesians chapter 5, maybe verse 22. Glory to God. I said glory to God. I said glory to God. Verse 22, wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church and is the savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject to Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in how many things? In how many things? That's why last week we started by saying marriage should be approached with all sense of gravity. Don't just marry, approach marriage casually. Marriage should be approached because when the chips are down, if the man says, this is where we must go, and you know it is actually headed for the ditch, God says, follow him.
You are loaded with great potentials, but somehow your life could seem empty and dry. All you need is the Word to come to the place of faith, blessing, and destiny. Your life can be maximized
because the Word of God says so. Because the Word of God says so.
Maximize your life with Dr. Chris Williams.